Hello everyone. Today we are going to see numericals on DC to DC converter, that is unit number 4. In our previous lectures, we have seen about what is chopper, what are the types of chopper, and each chopper, the chopper in detail. In this lecture, we will see numericals on step-up chopper, numericals on step-down chopper, AC voltage controller. Myself, Professor Amit Kumar Mishra. I'm having total 10 years of teaching experience and my domain expertise is of 10 years. So let's start with question one. A chopper circuit is operating on TRC at a frequency of 2 kHz on a 460 volt supply. If the load voltage is 350 volts, calculate the conduction period of the thyristor in each cycle. So input voltage is DC, that is 460 volt, it is given in the question, and output voltage is again variable DC, that is of 350 volts. Frequency is given of 2 kHz. So what is chopping period T? That is 1 upon F. So if you substitute the value of F as 2 kHz, 2 into 10 raised to power 3, we are going to get T as 0.5 milliseconds. And VDC is T on upon T into V. With that, we substitute the value of each, we will be getting as T on is equal to 0.38 milliseconds. Question number two. Input to the step-up chopper is 200 volt. The output required is 600 volt. If the conducting time of thyristor is 200 microsecond, compute chopping frequency. And if the pulse width is half for constant frequency of operation, find the new output voltage. That means in the question, input voltage is given as 200 volt, T on is given as 200 microsecond, VDC is given as 600 volt. Therefore, we know that VDC is equal to V into T upon T minus T on. So what is VDC? It is 600. What is V? It is 200. So T we have to find out. So T will be, we are going to substitute T on, which is given in the question as 200 microsecond. So if you substitute all those values, we are going to get T as 300 microsecond. Now chopping frequency. So chopping frequency will be what? F is equal to 1 by T. We just found T, that is 300 microsecond. So if you substitute the value of T as 300 microsecond over there, then we will be getting F is equal to 1 by 300 into 10 raised to power minus 6, which is equal to 3.33 kilohertz. Now in the question, second point is, if the pulse width is half for the constant frequency of operation, find the new output voltage. That means what? If T on is half, that means T on in the question is given as 200 microsecond. If it is half, that means it becomes 100 microsecond, then frequency is constant. So F will remain same, that is 3.33 kilohertz. T will be 1 by F, so that is 300 microsecond. So output voltage is V into T by T minus T on. So V is 200, T is 300 into 10 raised to power minus 6. T is, again, we have to substitute that T on is 100 microsecond. So output voltage will be 300 volts. Question number three. A DC chopper has a resistive load of 20 ohm and input voltage of 220 volt. When chopper is on, its voltage drop is 1.5 volts and chopping frequency is 10 kilohertz. If the duty cycle is 80%, determine the average output voltage and chopper on time. That means in the question, Vs is given as 220 volt, R is given as 20 ohm, F is 10 kilohertz. So D will be T on upon T, that is 0.8. Chopper voltage drop across the chopper is given as 1.5 volts. So average output voltage will be what? VDC is equal to T on upon T into Vs minus VCH. So T on upon T is 0.8, Vs is 220, what is VCH? It is 1.5. So if we substitute all those values, we are going to get VDC is equal to 174.8 volts. Now, chopper on time. That means T on is equal to small d into T, where small d is duty cycle and T is chopper time, total time, T. So chopping period T is equal to 1 by F. F is given in the question. So T will be what? 1 upon 10 into 10 raised to power 3, So T will be 100 microsecond. Chopper on time. Chopper on time is alpha, that is D into T. So this is duty cycle into T. T we just got, that is 100 microsecond. D is given over here. Just we got this D as 0.80. It is given in the question also. Duty cycle is 80%. So T on will be 0.80 into duty into total time, which is 0.1 into 10 raised to power minus 3. So T on is 0.08 into 10 raised to power minus 3. So T on will be 80 microseconds. Next question. A DC chopper in figure has a resistive load of R is equal to 10 ohm and input voltage of V is equal to 200 volt. When the chopper is on, its output voltage is 2 volt and chopping frequency is 1 kilohertz. If the duty cycle is 60%, determine average output voltage, RMS value of output voltage, effective input resistance of chopper and chopper efficiency. So V is 200 volt, R is given in the question as 10 ohm, chopper voltage is 2 volt, duty cycle is 0.6, F is 1 kilohertz. We know that average output voltage in this case will be VDC is equal to D into V minus VCH. So what is D? D is 0.6. What is V? 200. What is VCH? It is 2. So if you substitute all those values, then we will be getting VDC is equal to 118.8 volts. RMS value of output voltage will be V0 is equal to under root of D, that means duty cycle, into V minus VCH. So under root of D means under root of 0.6. V is 200 and VCH is 2. So if we substitute all those values, we are going to get V0 as 153.37 volts. Effective input resistance of chopper is RI is equal to V upon IS or V upon IDC. What is IDC then? It will be VDC upon R. So VDC is 118.8. R is given in the question as 10. So what is IDC? IDC will be 11.88 amperes. Then RI. RI will be V upon IS or V upon IDC. So V is 200. IDC just we got 11.88. So RI will be 16.83 ohm. Then output power. So output power is 1 by T integration 0 to DT. D means duty cycle. T is chopping. That is chopping period. So into V naught square upon R into DT. So it is 1 by T. Integration 0 to dt V minus VCH square upon R into dt. Therefore, P0 is equal to D into V minus VCH square upon R. What is D? It is 0.6. V is 200. VCH is 2 square. R is 10. So total output power will be what? Output power will be 2352.24 watts. Input power. Input power is 1 by T, 0 to 1 by T, integration 0 to DT, VI naught DT. VI naught DT. So P naught is equal to 1 by T, integration 0 to DT, V into V minus VCH upon R into DT. Therefore, P naught is equal to dV V minus VCH upon R. How we are getting this? So it is 1 by T. This will be constant. So this is DT. So integration of this DT will give you this DT term over here minus 0 because lower limit is 0. So this DT when it comes over here, so this capital T and this T will get cancelled. So we will be getting as V, that small d, V minus VCH upon R. The same thing we are getting over here. That is dV V minus VCH upon R. So we are going to substitute the value of each term, that is alpha, which is in our case it is D, duty cycle, V, VCH and R. So we will be getting P naught as 2376 watts. Now, chopper efficiency. What is chopper efficiency? It is P naught upon PI into 100. What is P naught? It is 2352.24. What is PI? 2376 into 100. So we will be getting chopper efficiency as 99%. Next topic is AC to AC converters. AC to AC converters have a wide range used in the industry. Applications of AC to AC converters are light dimmers, AC motor controllers, heat controllers, uninterruptible power supplies. They produce an output voltage at the same frequency as input signal, input AC signal with variable amplitudes. Single phase AC voltage controller. So this is, we have two thyristors. We are giving AC from here, that is fixed, and we are getting variable AC over here. Let's see how we are getting that. So once we are giving input AC, positive half cycle, when it comes, so this is positive, this is negative. This is positive means this is positive. This is positive means this side is positive as well as this side is positive. Now, this thyristor is having P on this side. So T1 will become forward bias during the positive half cycle. This positive and this is anode, cathode of the thyristor T4. So cathode will be, T4 will be reverse biased. So what will happen is current will flow in this way and we will get output across load. During negative half cycle, this is negative, this is positive. This is negative means this is negative, this is negative, this is negative. Now this is anode of the thyristor T1. So it is reverse biased. This is cathode of the thyristor T4, so it will be forward biased during negative half cycle. So the current will flow in this way and we are going to get the output across the load. So let's see the waveform. Here, this is the input AC we are triggering during each half cycle. Here we have triggered T1, here we have triggered T4, here T1 and again T4. So once we trigger, we are getting the output. For positive half cycle, we are getting positive output. For negative half cycle, we are getting the negative output. So this is fixed input AC and we are getting variable output AC. The above figure or graph curve is of voltage and lower is of current. The shape of current and voltage is same for resistive load, only the magnitude difference. Why? Because we know that V is equal to IR. So for resistive load, V is directly proportional to I. So that's why the shape of I will be same as that of the voltage. Only the difference is of magnitude because I is V upon R. This is the drop across thyristors. Means if we are giving the positive AC cycle, and we are getting this much of output. That means for this part, we are not getting the output. So where it is going, so it is the drop across the device. So this is the drop. Similarly, in negative half cycle, we are getting this much as an output. So for negative half cycle, we are getting this much as an output. So this much we are not getting. So that is the drop across the load, drop across the thyristors. So what is the RMS output voltage for AC to AC converter? So RMS output voltage for AC to AC converter is VF under root of 1 by pi alpha minus pi minus alpha plus 1 by 2 sine 2 alpha. In this lesson, we have learned numerical on step-up chopper, numerical on step-down chopper, and single-phase AC voltage controller. Thank you.